हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल मन्हा स्टडी कॉर्नर। लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर जर्नी विद द चैप्टर सेट्स। लेट्स जस्ट गो टू द ग्रुप्स दैट आई हैव हियर। मे बी यू कैन ऐड सम मोर टू माय लिस्ट। सो दीज वेर द ग्रुप्स दैट आई थॉट ऑफ। द फर्स्ट वन वॉज द लिस्ट ऑफ प्लेयर्स फ्रॉम ऑल द 14 कंट्रीज। प्रीटी सिंपल राइट? यू कैन इजिली फिल दिस आउट। लेट्स ट्राई फिलिंग दिस आउट, नॉट वेरी डिफिकल्ट। हियर आर ऑल द 14 कंट्रीज एंड द प्लेयर्स। The second group that I thought of was batsmen who scored a century. Pretty difficult, right? But the amount of stats that are available these days, when you look at a match actually, the stats are pretty impressive. So enough stats available, filling in with batsmen with a century, not difficult at all. So here are all the batsmen that hit a century. Let's try something more fun. What about players who played well? This should be more fun, right? Kohli was, I think, fantastic in the World Cup. Clearly, it's gonna be really tough for us to agree, right? I'm not gonna get into this battle. Let's keep this group aside for a minute. Let's think of an easier way. What about bowlers who batted well? Would it be a fun group? I'm guessing not. It's again not very easy to fit. So what's happening here? There are some groups that are much, much easier to fill than the others, right? Let me just separate for you. So on this side, we have the groups of batsmen who scored a century, players in World Cup, easy ones to fill. The one on my left side are much harder to fill. Why? Why do you think it is so? Exactly. The easier to fill groups, these are facts that none of us can disagree, or we can say that they are well defined. The groups other than these are completely opposite. They are based on opinion and not at all on facts. And each of us are entitled to have different opinion, right? So in this case, the group is not well defined. The group that is well defined, we can call it as sets. The group that is not well defined, we can simply call it as groups. They are not really set. So what we have seen is sets are a well defined collection of distinct objects. In other words, a well defined group. If you were to write the set of players in the World Cup 2015 Indian team, we'll just list down all the players, separate them by commas, add curly brackets, and we have a set. As simple as that. Every object in this group, a player in this case, is called an element of the set. And well defined, we saw, meant that given an element, we can be sure it belongs to a set or not. So let me ask you a question. Write down the set of all cricketers who have ever played in the World Cup. Even if you know everyone who have ever played a World Cup, it would take ages to list all of them down. There's got to be a simpler, smaller way of doing this, right? Fortunately, there is. So I will simply write this as Team World Cup is a list of all X such that X has played a cricket World Cup. What have I done here? Instead of writing down every element, I just wrote down the common property that each element of the set possesses. So, if you would write the set of all batsmen who scored a century, we would say X such that X scored a century in the Cricket World Cup. You could do the same thing with boring mathematical sets like natural numbers too. N is a set of X such that X is a natural number. So any finite set, list out the elements, count the number of elements, that would be the cardinality. If you take a typical cricket playing team, there will be 11 players in the team. So the cardinality of the set will be 11. That's all that cardinality means. When I was closely following the match between India and Pakistan, I noticed that Virat Kohli was the only Indian who scored a century in that match. So, If I were to make a set of all Indians who scored a century in that match, we will have only one element in that set, that is Virat Kohli. We call such a set as singleton set, a set with one element, that is Virat Kohli. Now, in the same match, what if I were to make a set of Indians who took 5 wickets? Is there anyone who did that? Unfortunately, no. So, this set would be a null set, a set with no element. Let's consider the playing level between the matches against Pakistan, South Africa and UAE. Most likely everything should be the same. If you observe the teams of matches against Pakistan and South Africa, they are exactly the same. We call such sets as equal sets. Both the sets are exactly the same. So let's consider set of teams India played against. If we put down all the teams, each element of this set is a set in itself, right? Australia is a set of Australian players. South Africa is a set of South African players. Pakistan is a set of Pakistan team. So every element in this large set, we have here, is a set in a set. So we call set a set, set of set. So every element is also a set, not just an object in a set. So the next thing we come to is called as subset. The name tells you something, right? It's a set and then I take a part of it and I call it as a subset. Suppose I write a set as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then I take a part of it, that is 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3 will be called as subset of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nothing but a set in which subset is a part of. So if I had a set A is equals to 1, 2, 3 and I have one more set B is equals to 1, 2, 3. So they are equal sets. Equal sets are also proper subsets of each other. A subset simply means every element in the subset should be present in superset. So let's say we have a set A with elements 1 and 2. One subset would be the null set. Null set is nothing but subset of all sets because everything contains nothing. The other one will be just 1, then just 2, then 1 and 2. So all of these are nothing but subsets. How many subsets does A have in this case? 4. 4 is nothing but 2 square, right? Why did we get 2 square? Because the cardinality of our original set is 2. You will always get 2 raised to cardinality. Let's try out one more set. Let's say we have set B with elements 1, 2 and 3. Now what would all the subsets be? We'll have the null set first, then just 1, just 2, just 3, then 1, 2, then 2, 3, then 1, 3, and then 1, 2, 3. So how many subsets did you get? 8, right? 8 is nothing but 2 raised to 3. The same thing again, we got 2 raised to cardinality. There is one superset of all set that is called universal set. If we are discussing about the World Cup, universal set would be set of all players from all the world, right, from the all countries. The players together, that would be a superset. Any discussion regarding the players in this World Cup would involve players from that set. So for this discussion, universal set would be the set of all players who played in this World Cup. A universal set is simply nothing but, in very simple words, a superset of all possible subsets that we are going to discuss. It need not be very it need not be why universal set would be all cricketers. Another universal set would be every person who has ever played cricket. They are all universal sets, right? Another would be the entire population of world. But typically what we take as a universal set is only that part which is relevant to our discussion. There's no point in talking everybody who's there in the world. If you're talking about the Cricket World Cup, universal set would be sufficient to have just people who played in this World Cup. So that is what a universal set is. It's what basically a universal set is, a superset of all possible subsets that we are going to discuss. So that's all for today. If you have any doubts, please feel free to ask in the comment section below. Hit a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.